I am a neuroscientist. My work currently focuses on how the retina processes light signals from our environment.
And I'm a sculptor and an artist. My work is about like material meaning and like cultural interpretations of objects. I think we're both like into like looking and the act of looking.
Seeing is maybe thought to be an objective experience, but it's actually quite subjective from person to person.
We like set out initially without a final product.
Right.
And so we were more interested in kind of like having conversations.
Do you remember our first conversation? Not really. I think we just talk so much.
You shared with me your dissertation paper.
Uh-huh.
And the first thing I did with your dissertation paper was cut it up and cut each word out. And I was just using it to like find language and try to like think about the way that the language was engaging with the subject matter, and also trying to compare the visual language of neuroscience with the visual language of sculpture and visual art.
I was really interested in how people can perceive color. I took a survey of 70 different people and asked them to identify shades of colors with different words.
Certain colors, like everyone had the same definition,
right.
And certain words like were
really
way
cool.
Out there. Jen would come here and we would like hang out and work. Like, you got shop authorized. But then I like went to your lab. I watched you dissect a mouse's retina.
What I actually study is a certain type of cell that is activated only when objects are moving in a certain direction. All of that information gets sent from the retina to other parts of the brain.
This retina, it was like floating in water. And I was just thinking about like the subject of your experiments floating in the water. And then I was just thinking about like the lake, and I was thinking about swimming in the lake, and I was thinking about me floating in the water and kind of what that felt like. And then there was just like a realization that like I am the subject of my own experiments. And in a way we were talking
You're
about-
You're both the experimenter and
yeah,
subject.
Yeah, like being an artist is like a weird discipline of like doing experiments on yourself or something.
And I think we wanted to pursue a lot of smaller projects. And so having things be documented in a book where you can really decide the layout and decide how many pages to dedicate to each little mini project, I think that is ideal for us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's like evidence of
the conversations and the progression of our collaboration. We are both interested in how the craft of science and art can be seen.
I feel like I needed to talk to a scientist to figure out what it meant to be an artist.